Go.
Our second major finding, even black children as a whole have some bias toward whiteness, but far less than white children.
She'll be the smart child. And why is she the smart child?
Because she is white.
Okay. Show me the dumb child. And why is she the dumb child?
Because she plays.
Well, show me the ugly child. And why is she the ugly child?
Because she plays.
Show me the good-looking child. And why is she the good-looking child?
Because she likes skinny.
And show me the skin color you believe most teachers think looks bad on a girl.
I don't think they think it matters. Because I think each teacher wants to help a student learn either way what they look like. And
yeah.
Like, it doesn't matter what you look like on the outside. It just matters what you look like on the inside.
Show me the good-looking child.
They look the same.
Yeah? Show me the child you would like as a classmate.
All of them.
You like all of them as classmates?
Mm-hmm.
Why do you say all of them?
Because I don't really care what color they have.
This 5-year-old girl gave some provocative answers during her test. I asked her about them later.
Why don't you? Why do you want that skin color?
Because it looks lighter than this kind, because this looks a lot like that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And I just don't like the way brown looks, because the way brown looks really nasty for some reason, but I don't know what reason. That's all.
So you think it looks nasty?
Well, not really, but sometimes.
Sometimes. And Brielle, they asked what color adults don't like. Do you remember what you said? Which one? That's right, that's what you said. Why do you think adults don't like that color?
Dark.
Dark. And adults, you think adults don't like dark?
Well, maybe some adults do, but maybe some of them don't.
Mm.
The questions that got overwhelmingly white-biased answers?
Show me the one you think most children would think looks bad on a boy.
More than 70% of the older black children chose the darkest skin tones.
Show me the child who has the skin color most children don't like.
More than 61% of the younger black children chose the two darkest shades.
Show me the ugly child.
More than 57% of the younger black kids chose the two darkest shades. Dr. Spencer says the research shows the bias toward white is still very much part of our culture.
All kids are exposed to these stereotypes, but what's really significant here is that white children are learning or maintaining those stereotypes much more strongly than the African American children.
And that is our third finding, the finding that interested Dr. Spencer the most, that overall younger and older children keep the same patterns stereotyping. In other words, their ideas change little from age 5 to 10.
Ordinarily, by the time children are older, there's sort of a natural filter, you know, their own ways of thinking sort of aids them in sort of rethinking the extreme stereotypic sort of responses to become less highly biased.
That left Professor Spencer wondering what's causing this pattern. She speculates that kids are bombarded by stereotypical messages and that adults in kids' lives have to fight to override the deluge. Black parents may be more diligent about that, while white parents may not notice the need.
The messages are the same for all children, and therefore the task is the same for all parents. Parents have to reframe what children experience.
We realize these findings may be disturbing and that some people will question this project's conclusions. What stereotypic messages are being sent in a country that elected a black man president?
Hi, Barack Hussein Obama.
Like all research projects, ours is not perfect. Some kids were told ahead of time they'd be asked about race. Some children identified as one race but came from biracial families, like this boy whose mom is white. But Professor Spencer tells us these are common issues in research and the results can still be trusted because of the sample size. To be clear, this is a scientifically informed and executed pilot study, which suggests the need for further research. The results point to major trends, but are not the definitive word on children and race. Still, they underline what Dr. Spencer sees as an alarming conclusion.
We are still living in a society where dark things are devalued and light things are valued.
The question we're left with is, where do we go from here? Anderson Cooper, CNN.